Let's take a look at the different options for controlling the representation and visibility of rebar elements. Through object styles located in the Manage tab, you can set properties like line color and thickness for rebar elements project-wide, just like with any other Revit element. Rebars are divided into different subcategories depending on the bar diameter. This allows, for example, each diameter to be represented in different color. Rebar shape details belong to the detail item category and are split in four subcategories: total, partial shapes, with thick and thin lines. This differentiation is necessary because rebars and shape details can be represented in different ways depending on the level of detailing, either with two lines or just the bar axis. This can be seen in the coarse level of detail, which is shown here, since changing the level of detail for an entire view affects not only the reinforcement but also other elements. You can adjust the level of detail for individual categories using the shortcut VV. However, it is recommended to make such adjustments uniformly using appropriate view templates for reinforcement views. Let's go back and reset the level of detail back to medium. Now, let's switch to the top view of our sheet. During the detailing process, you may have encountered the issue that only the column reinforcement was visible, but not the beam reinforcement. We indirectly learned about this special visibility condition through the unobstructed tool. This allows control over which view an element appears as unobstructed. In other words, it's not covered by concrete. Additionally, we can see that the column reinforcement is displayed with a lighter appearance than the beam reinforcement. This is due to a filter that can be accessed through the VV shortcut on the filter tab. Filters can override the visibility and representation of certain elements. Here, the reinforcement that does not belong to the RC03 beam sheet is displayed in halftone. By using rule-based element overrides, we ensure the desired representation consistently. If additional bars are later modeled in the column or floor sheet, they will be filtered out and overwritten accordingly. As an exercise, let's create a practice view in which the reinforcement is displayed in a different color depending on the sheet assignment. To do this, we will duplicate the 3D reinforcement view in the project browser. And we will rename it as well to 3D reinforcement assignments. The 3D view is linked to a view template and has an overall transparency of 20%. To improve visibility, we will also bring the rebars to the foreground using the unobstructed tool. Now, open the visibility and representation override dialog again using VV. We switch to the filters tab. Click on Edit/New to create a new filter, and let's create a new one and name it Rebar on Sheet _ Beams. We enable all reinforcement categories: the fabric area, fabrics, path reinforcement, rebars, and the couplers. Using the filter rules, specify that we only want to see selected elements whose SOFiSTiK assignment parameter is equal to RC03. The drop-down menu already includes all the values assigned to this parameter in the project. However, we can also enter new values that do not yet exist in the project. We confirm the dialog with OK, select our filter again in the next dialog, and we now can control what happens to the filtered out elements. We could disable the visibility, enable halftone presentation, or override their overall representation. We override the surface pattern with a solid fill and green color. We override the project lines with a darker green than the other surfaces to ensure that the rebars remain visible at intersection points. Confirm the changes and let's check the results in our 3D view. Now, please create 3 additional filters for the foundation, column, and floor sheet, and choose different colors for the overrides. I also recommend trying the approach of duplicating and modifying existing filters.